हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ केमिस्ट्री सेशन फॉर क्लास नाइन्थ एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग थ्रू द टॉपिक स्टेट्स ऑफ मैटर. एज यू हैव स्टडीड अर्लियर दैट यू कैन सी डिफरेंट मैटर अराउंड यू एंड यू कैन सी दैट मैटर एग्जिस्ट इन थ्री स्टेट्स, दैट इज सॉलिड, सॉलिड लिक्विड एंड गैस. इट एग्जिस्ट इन थ्री स्टेट्स, सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड गैस. टू नो मोर अबाउट सॉलिड स्टेट वी कैन परफॉर्म एन एक्टिविटी. वॉट वी विल डू इन दिस एक्टिविटी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कलेक्ट सम आर्टिकल्स फ्रॉम योर सराउंडिंग like a pen, a pencil, a notebook, and one more thing you can select and then draw a sketch of each of the article with pencil. What do you find? Do they have a different shape and size? Yes, they have different shape and size, and they have definite volume. Now, apply some force on each article by hammering. What do you observe? You will observe that on applying force, these articles have tendency to maintain their shape. Now, try to compress them one by one. What do you observe? You will observe that when you apply some force, these articles are least compressible. Okay? So, you can note it as collect some articles from your surrounding, like a pen, a needle, a pencil, and an ink pot. Now, in second step, draw sketch of each article now observe. What do you observe? Do they have a different shape? Yes, they have different shape and size and they have fixed volume. Okay. Now, try to compress them one by one. What do you observe? These articles, try to compress them. What do you observe? You will observe that they are least compressible. Okay. Now, hammer them and observe. So, what do you observe by hammering? They maintain, they have tendency to maintain their shape. Okay. So, by this activity, we can conclude some properties of solid state. What are these properties? These properties are, number one, they have definite shape and size. And fixed volume. Number two, they are least diffusible, means we cannot diffuse them, and next is they are least compressible, and next, they have high density and next, the particles in solid state have very low kinetic energy. And next one, they have very less inter particle space. And the last one, they have very strong force of attraction between the particles. What are the properties? They have definite shape, size and definite volume, and you can see they are least diffusible, they are least compressible, means by applying force we can compress them at least. They have high density. The particles in solid state have very low kinetic energy. That's why in solid state the particles do not move from their position. They have very less interparticle space, means particles of matter are very closely packed, and they have very strong force of attraction between the particles. Due to strong force of attraction, these particles held together and do not leave their position. That's why solids have tendency to maintain their shape. Okay. Now, take a screenshot of it. Now, let us see what are the properties of matter in liquid state. Let us perform an activity. For this, what we will do? Collect some liquids like cooking oil, water, milk, and then collect containers of different shape. First of all, we collect some liquids from your surrounding like cooking oil, milk, water and other liquids also, and then we collect some containers having different shape. Now, in third step, mark 50 ml in each container by using measuring cylinder, measuring cylinder. Measuring cylinder is actually graduated cylinder, and it is used in the laboratories. So, with the help of measuring cylinder, we mark 50 ml in each containers which we have collected from the surrounding having different shape. And then in the next step, pour a liquid in a container out of these liquids. We can take any liquid and we pour it in a container, and then transfer it transfer the liquid in different containers. Different containers, and then observe what do you observe when we transfer 50 ml liquid in different container. They adopt different shape, but they have definite volume. In each container they have 50 ml. Like we can see the different containers, like you can take flask, you can take conical flask. This is conical flask. You can take container like this. And in each mark 50 ml. These are the different containers. When we transfer 50 ml liquid in a container and then transfer this liquid in different containers, every time they have definite volume, that is 50 ml, but they have different shape. So, we observe that they acquire the shape of container, shape of containers, and they have definite volume. Okay. Now we can conclude the properties of these liquids, liquid state. Number one, properties they have definite volume, but no definite shape. No definite shape. Next property. They have property of fluidity, means liquids can flow. Next one is they are compressible, next one is the particles have more inter-particle space. Next one is they are diffusible, means liquids can easily diffuse. Next, the particles of liquid have more kinetic energy, and next one is liquids are compressible. Okay, so these are some properties of liquids, that they have definite volume but they do not have definite shape, because when they are transferred they take the shape of container, that's why they have only definite volume but no definite shape. One more thing, most important thing is they have property of fluidity, means liquids can flow, and they are compressible. By applying force we can compress the liquid. The particles of liquid have more kinetic energy, that's why within the boundary they can move from one position to another position, that's why they have property of fluidity. And one more thing is they have more interparticle space, that's why they have less force of attraction between the particles, so they can flow. Now take a screenshot of it. Now in this session I have discussed the properties of matter in solid state and in liquid state. In the next video I will discuss properties of matter in gaseous state and some more topics also. Now this session is over. Thank you, students.